Okay. Hi guys, welcome to the new video. Today I'm gonna be watching FAT Acceptance Mega Compilation. If you are new to the channel, subscribe, leave some comment. I upload everyday video. Yeah, and check it out, 50 Shades channel. He is awesome dude. He agreed that I can react to a couple of his videos, so yeah, link in the description. It's funny stuff. Okay, let's watch. I'm gonna turn down the volume.
People's body size is deeply linked with race.
Whoa! Oh! I like the music, okay?
I have a doctor. I don't need 6 billion doctors.
What the fuck? Oh no! No! Shit! Okay, this is very good edit. Offended this time of content? Watch. Okay, I don't finish reading.
Weight discrimination. She says she did not get hired because of her size.
Those aren't real women. Real women are not that size.
The restaurant's response and why the law might not be on her side.
Now that woman was hoping to get a job as a server at a League City pub. Hello, I'm Dominique Soxa.
I'm Bill Baessa. Thank you for joining us. Here's what's happened instead. When Sarah Brady showed up for that interview, she says she was turned away despite her qualifications.
Channel 2's Jennifer Bauer is at the Tilted Kilt pub right off of the Gulf Freeway. She's joining us live now with Brady's complaint and the pub's response. Jen?
Okay.
Well, this bar is not open yet. In fact, you can see on the sign it says coming soon. You can also see on the sign that the waitresses here wear very skimpy outfits, and that's exactly why a local
woman
said
free promotion,
she
yeah.
wasn't hired.
Meet Sarah Brady. Sometimes I don't even know if these people are serious. There's plenty of other jobs she can do. She can be an office worker or even a truck driver. The possibilities are endless.
Sarah Brady was hoping to get hired as a waitress
yeah,
or even bartender
point.
At the new Tilted Kilt pub opening soon in League City, but was shocked when she showed up for her interview and was turned away.
Thank you for coming and applying, but we've already filled all of the positions with more experienced candidates.
Sarah believes she was turned away because of her size.
I was really mad. I knew it probably had to do with I did not portray the brand image that they wanted.
Yeah.
A brand image that is advertised on their website. Kilt girls wear short skirts and small tops.
Real women are not that size.
In an email, a representative for Tilted
okay.
Kilt told Channel 2 our hiring and employment
so
practices
like,
are in full compliance
not real
with all laws.
Women's.
When hiring, we seek entertainer servers who not only fit the costume, but exemplify a personality and skill set that is friendly, courteous, and customer-oriented.
There's no protection under the law for weight.
He says laws mm-hmm. protect people who are discriminated against for race, sex, national origin, religion, and disability. But that's it.
Now, there's nothing for bald-headed people. There's nothing for short people. There's nothing for heavy people.
Yeah.
There's just no protection under the law.
I hope that the next chubby girl, plus size, thick, whatever word you want to use to describe yourself goes in and interviews with them. I hope you get the job.
I don't think
so. Sarah Brady tells us she has battled an eating disorder in the past,
or maybe.
And now she says she is very proud of her body. We're live in League City. I'm Jennifer Bauer, KPRC, Channel 2 News.
Wow, this is not the news. What is this? That's why I don't watch TV. Seriously.
Hello. How y'all doing?
Surviving.
Surviving, huh? So, is that why you missed your last appointment?
Yeah, I watched some stuff with this doctor. He helping people, yeah? That
you just had
have
your bypass about 2 months ago. And when you left the hospital, you were down to 546. So, you lost only 9 pounds since then. Renee has lost almost 50 pounds. And she hasn't even had her bypass yet. What in the world is going on with you?
I guess I'm eating the wrong things.
You think it's funny? You well, have a gastric bypass.
I had a gastric bypass,
to
yes.
lose weight. and you're not losing weight.
I don't eat a third what I no, ate
just
before I had
the
that
question.
Surgery.
Then
you're
we're not
asking
talking
me
about
questions
that
I don't understand no more than you understand.
This
what
is
are
so
you talking
psychological.
About? You're
you
choosing
know,
to overeat, and you think it's okay?
No, I don't think it's okay at all.
So what is going on?
I guess I'm not eating the right things. I mean,
we gave you the instruction that you need to follow, and you never followed. And now you're playing this kind of game, and you think that's okay?
Yeah.
I don't see how I'm playing any game. I throw up constantly. I eat what I can keep down.
That's how it works. You throw up constantly because the surgery forces you to when you overeat.
My problem is I'm holding a lot of fluid. I can't hardly
eat. Come on. And the doctors try to help her, you know?
I don't know. What, I mean, you...
What do you mean you don't know?
This is
something that you're not eating and you're getting...
I don't want to get malnourished either.
Do you look like you are malnourished?
This is funny, but this is psychological thing, I think, you know? This is not some easy stuff to deal with that kind of weight. But the doctor wants to help her, you know? So she...
Well, a woman says she felt fat-shamed at Universal Orlando when she wasn't able to ride the King Kong attraction Skull Island.
She asked the crew if she could ride with one less person on the bench seat so she wouldn't make those sitting next to her feel uncomfortable. Channel 9's Lauren Seabrook sat down with her today. And Lauren, she says Universal staff refused that request.
And Greg, she says the whole thing was just humiliating. Universal doesn't have weight restrictions, so she didn't know she couldn't ride until she paid to get in and then was just about to get on.
This is actually my daughter's.
Angel Morales shares a love for Harry Potter with her daughters.
Yeah, Harry Potter.
Universal last year and couldn't wait to check out the Wizarding World. Angel spent a lot of money on souvenirs that first trip, but for her, the thrills fell short.
Couldn't fit on any of the Harry Potter rides because of my weight. Did a lot of bag holding in Diagon Alley and that kind of thing.
She hoped to ride Universal's King Kong attraction because the seat is a bench without a safety bar. But when they got to the
Voldemort.
Front, she told her daughter she didn't think they would fit without making others uncomfortable. A man in line overheard the conversation and offered to wait for the next ride, allowing Angel to go with her daughters. So on their second trip back to the park, Angel tried to avoid more embarrassment by asking the Skull Island crew if one less person could ride in her row. She says they wouldn't allow it because they had to push for capacity.
It's somewhat humiliating to have to ask for an accommodation because of one's weight. You know, that you have to put yourself out there and kind of beg to be able to ride and embarrass yourself because of weight.
Yes, I get it.
Angel filed a discrimination complaint with the Florida Commission on Human Relations,
you know,
and says she feels people who are overweight should be a protected class.
Their interest is getting bodies and getting money and not accommodating paying customers. That's how I felt.
I get it.
And Angel says Universal did offer her a $100 gift card plus dinner and a movie, but she does not plan to return to
the park. And then
which she accepted. She received a $100 gift card, free food and movie tickets, according to sources. But of course, that wasn't enough, and she still filed a complaint.
Okay. This is very, you know, strange line, because just go to the gym, but it's very psychological.
Hi. I'm award-winning fat activist and professional feminist killjoy, Virgie Tovar.
Be an ally to women, rather than an accomplice to patriarchy. Because, after all, patriarchy doesn't give a f*** about you, girl.
What is fucking this? This kind of stuff I hate it. You know, this bite right here. Fuck my English. They get excuses. Yeah, patriarchy, you know, system, man. Just go to the gym. Come on. Don't eat shit and go to the gym. Whoa. So I'm gonna make zero budget movie better than this.
Did you get the babe stretch mark distress call?
Yeah, my stretch mark lit up too.
Just go to the gym because it's healthier, okay? To your body, but this is just my opinion.
Dumpling? Where are you?
The this zero budget movie sucks. This short film sucks. Because the camera is shaking.
Babes, I couldn't find Chubby Dumpling.
We should all go look for her.
Let's split up and cover more ground.
Yeah.
Chubby Dumpling, where are you?
Oh my god, this is very bad movie. I'm gonna make better movie, seriously. Cause my camera don't gonna shake, I think. What is this? This is some crazy shit. Okay, she don't wanna eat vegetables, Tulsi. Fuck my English.
It's the vegetables.
Oh, come on. And they don't deny it that...
We need some machetes.
Vegetables.
Give fuck my English. Everything you've got.
Are healthy, yeah. What, they gonna fight the corn?
Who fucked you vegetables?
Or whatever.
Die, Kale, die!
Die, veggie scum!
Whoa, this is fucking bullshit.
You veggie sons of bitches killed my friend!
Come on, it's healthy to eat corn. But I'm not eating healthy, to be honest, but I know it's healthy. Fuck. This movie fucking sucks.
Cheers! The veggies have been vanquished! We're back!
Yeah, it's
look
very...
Look at what we can do when we work together to vanquish patriarchy!
I mean yes. Vegetables.
Yeah.
It's very easy to blame, you know, everything... on the patriarchy. Just go to the fucking gym.
What's up, y'all?
Because it's healthy.
In the last post, we were talking about self-discipline. So I wanted to go into that a little farther. I believe that self-discipline is the definition of self-love. That when you say that you love yourself, that means that you have behavior towards yourself that is loving. It's like you say to yourself, hey man, look, I know you want to eat that pizza and it'll be really good, you know,
yeah.
But I can't let you eat that, man, because if you eat that pizza, you're going to feel like shit, you know, and I love you too much to let you eat that. And I think the word discipline has kind of gotten a bad name. We think about it in terms of punishment. I'm not talking about discipline in that way. I'm talking about discipline in the sense that you forego immediate pleasure for the exchange of long-term self-respect. Self-discipline is self-love. If you want to be happy, you have to love yourself, which means you have
to
discipline your behavior. The road to sustained happiness is through disciplining your behavior.
Okay, I'm gonna just say go to the fucking gym.
American boy, American
I'm
boy.
Joking.
Take me on a trip, I'd like to go someday. Take me to the world, I'd like to see LA. I really want to come pick it with you. You'll be
oh shit,
American
this is
boy.
So good, edit. Nice. You know, I'm not eating vegetables, fuck my English, and healthy food. But I know it's fucking healthy, you know? So, but they doing this kind of shit, they, you know, doing this short movies that is shitty, and they deny that vegetables is fucking, you know, bullshit, yeah? And they wanna eat, you know, I don't know, some fucking cheeseburger or whatever, cause patriarchy. This is fucking stupid, you know? This is excuses and whatever, you know? This is some psychological stuff. And yeah, this is this was good video. Check it out one more time, 50 Shades channel. And you know, if I'm gonna be fucking like this, I'm gonna blame everything on the patriarchy, okay? So yeah, thank you for watching, and go to the fucking gym.